हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू आर वाचिंग ऑनलाइन साइंस क्लास। वी आर हियर टू प्रेजेंट ऑल द टॉपिक्स ऑफ द साइंस फ्रॉम क्लास 6 टू 12। इफ यू रियली लाइक द कंटेंट ऑफ आवर चैनल, प्लीज लाइक एंड सब्सक्राइब आवर चैनल एंड ऑल्सो प्रेस द बेल आइकॉन फॉर गेट द नोटिफिकेशन ऑफ नेक्स्ट वीडियो। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, just we are going to start our today's topic, that is from class 7, chapter number 12, motion and time. This is the part 1 of this chapter, motion and time. In our daily life routine, we usually see some object at rest and other in motion, like birds, flies, fish, swimming, plants moving around the sun. etc. or are in motion when object change its position with time. This is very very important. The change in position with time, we often perceive an object to be in motion. So how we can define the motion? The change in position of object with respect to time is known as a motion. Example: when the position of the car changes with time, we say that the car is moving or car is in motion. If the car remains stationary throughout the day in a garage, what we will say? We will say that the car is at rest. So the main cause of the motion of any object is the change in position of object with respect to time. Type of motion. The motion of all objects are not of same time. There are four different type of motion shown by different object. First is the rectilinear motion. The motion possessed by the body moving along straight line. This is very important. This is also known as the straight line motion. The motion possessed by the body moving along a straight line is called rectilinear motion or motion in straight line. Example: the motion of a train on a straight bridge is known as the rectilinear motion. Next is the circular motion. The motion possessed by the body when it moves along a circular path, it is called circular motion. Example: the motion of the child in a merry-go-round. Motion of the earth around the sun in a circular orbit. We can take another example. The motion of the needle of the clock is also an example of the circular motion. So in daily life, we can see different type of the objects is performing circular motion. Rotational motion. The motion possessed by a body when it spins about a fixed axis is called rotational motion. This is very very important. Example: the motion of the earth about its axis spinning top, the motion of the blade of the fan, all are example of rotational motion. Here any object is moving around any particular axis. This is known as the rotational motion. Next is the periodic motion. The motion in which repeat itself after regular interval of time is called periodic motion. Example: the motion of the swing to and fro, motion of the simple pendulum. Such as, if you want to take example, we can take the example of the simple pendulum. This is a simple pendulum where a bob is suspended by the string, and if we are going to displace, it will start to perform periodic motion, it will move to and fro about its mean position. This motion is known as the simple harmonic motion or periodic motion. We will read in detail of this motion in our next topic. Slow or fast motion, an object which takes a long time to cover a certain distance is known as slow, while other object which takes shorter time to cover the same distance is known as a fast. Example, if your school is at a distance of 5 km from your home and you want to go to school by bicycle, then it takes about 25 minutes to reach the school. And if you want to go school by school bus, then same distance can be covered only in 10 minutes. It means that bicycle takes longer time than the bus. The most convenient way to determine which of the two objects is moving faster is to compare the distance moved by them in unit time, which is known as the speed. So how can we know? If you want to know any object is moving slow or fast, we will find out the distance covered by the two objects in same interval of time. The object which cover a which the object which cover the same distance in lesser amount of time is moving with faster in comparison to other object which take more times to cover the same distance. So this is the way by which we can know whether the object is moving slow or fast. Speed. The distance traveled by an object per unit time is known as speed. Either in 1 hour or in 1 minute or in 1 second is known as speed of that object. A slow object moving is said to have slow speed, and fast object moving is said to have high speed. So if we know the distance covered by two of buses in 1 hour, then we can answer which one is slower. Therefore, the formula for calculating the speed of an object can be given by speed is equal to distance upon time. This is the formula. This is very, very important, because this formula is used to calculate the speed of different objects. Example, if a car travel a distance of 100 km in 2 hours, then the speed of this car is given by speed is equal to distance upon time. If you want to calculate, we can calculate in such a way. Speed is equal to distance upon time, where distance is 100 kilometer and time is 2 hour. Always place the value with unit. The kilometer and hour is unit. Then solve it. This will solve by 50, and the answer will be 50 kilometer per hour. So this is the way by which we can calculate the speed of any object. It's so that the car will travel a distance of 50 km in 1 hour. It does not matter if a car seldom move with constant speed. This is very important word. The constant meaning द स्पीड ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट डज नॉट चेंज विद रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम. सो कॉन्स्टेंट स्पीड फॉर 1 आवर एज इट स्टार्ट मूविंग स्लोली एंड देन पिक अप स्पीड. जनरली वेन एवर वी आर राइडिंग अ बाइसिकल और कार और बाइक, वी विल इंक्रीज द स्पीड ऑफ द साइकिल कार और बाइक देन डिक्रीज द स्पीड देन दिस होल प्रोसेस विल परफॉर्म विद द डिफरेंट स्पीड. सो वेन वी से दैट कार मूविंग विद स्पीड ऑफ 50 किलोमीटर पर आवर, देन वी डू नॉट बॉदर वेदर द कार हैज बीन मूविंग विद कॉन्स्टेंट स्पीड और नॉट ड्यूरिंग दैट आवर. देयरफॉर द स्पीड कैलकुलेटेड हेयर इज एवरेज स्पीड ऑफ द कार. इट मीन्स दैट समटाइम इट मे बी हैपन दैट द स्पीड ऑफ द कार मे इंक्रीज एंड मे डिक्रीज, बट व्हेनेवर वी आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट द स्पीड ऑफ एनी ऑब्जेक्ट, इट इज द एवरेज स्पीड विच इज कैलकुलेटेड बाय द टोटल डिस्टेंस कवर्ड बाय द ऑब्जेक्ट डिवाइडेड बाय टोटल टाइम टेकन बाय द ऑब्जेक्ट. दिस इज नोन एज द एवरेज स्पीड, दैट इज द टोटल डिस्टेंस ऑन टोटल टाइम. इट मे बी हैपन दैट ड्यूरिंग द जर्नी द स्पीड ऑफ द कार मे इंक्रीज फ्रॉम 50 किलोमीटर पर आवर टू 60 और मे डिक्रीज फ्रॉम 50 to 40, बट वेन एवर वी आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट वी विल टेक द टोटल डिस्टेंस एंड टोटल टाइम एंड दिस विल गिव द एवरेज स्पीड ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट. वी कैन राइट द फॉर्मूला इन अनदर वे, डिस्टेंस इज इक्वल टू स्पीड इनटू टाइम इफ यू वांट टू फाइंड आउट द डिस्टेंस कवर्ड बाय द ऑब्जेक्ट. नेक्स्ट टाइम इज इक्वल टू डिस्टेंस अपॉन स्पीड. सो दिस इज द सेम फॉर्मूला बट आर रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय डिफरेंट फिजिकल यूनिट. मैथड टू चेंज यूनिट ऑफ स्पीड. दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज समटाइम वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द स्पीड ऑफ द एनी ऑब्जेक्ट इन डिफरेंट यूनिट टू कन्वर्ट फ्रॉम मीटर पर सेकेंड टू किलोमीटर पर आवर. जस्ट सी 1 किलोमीटर इज इक्वल टू 1000 मीटर, ऑल ऑफ यू नो. ओके, 1 आवर इज इक्वल टू 60 मिनट एंड 1 मिनट इज इक्वल टू 60 सेकेंड. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू चेंज इट विल कन्वर्ट 1000 मीटर अपॉन 3600 सेकेंड. If you would like to solve it, so this will 2 5 ja 10 and 18 2 ja 36, so it will form 5/18 or 1/3.6. So it is very important conclusion to convert from kilometer per hour to meter per second. We will divide by 3.6. और 18.5. फ्रॉम मीटर पर सेकेंड टू किलोमीटर पर आवर जस्ट सी द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द एरो, वी विल मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 3.6 और 18/5. दिस इज द शॉर्टकट मेथड. वी विल चेंज डिफरेंट वैल्यू ऑफ स्पीड फ्रॉम किलोमीटर पर आवर टू मीटर पर सेकेंड इन अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. Now we will see an example where the speed of an object is 72 km/h and we want to change it into meter per second. So dear students, we will see how can we change it. Speed is 72 km/h. We know that in 1 kilometer there is 1000 meter and in 1 hour there is 60 minute. In next step, we will write it 72 into 1000 meter and 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So 60, here we will convert the minute into the second, that is 60 seconds. Now we will solve it. 72 into 1000 upon 3600 second. Here we will write the unit of distance, that is meter, and unit of time, that is the second. Now we will solve it. It is equal to 72 into 5 upon 18 is equal to 18 4 ja 72, 20 meter per second. So by this way we can convert kilometer per hour into meter per second. Just see, dear students, in whole of the process, what the final change here you can say, if you want to change kilometer per hour into meter per second, we can multiply it with the help of 5 by 18. This is the shortcut method, but in detail, you can convert step by step by converting kilometer per hour into the meter per second by this way. Now we will take another example. Speed of an object is 30 meter per second. Change this speed into kilometer per hour. Now we will understand how can we change it. Speed is 30 meter per second. We know that 30 into in 1 meter, 1 upon 1000 kilometer. All of you know that. And in 1 second, there is 1 upon 3600 hour. Now what will happen? We can write in this way, 30 into 3600 upon 1000 into, here the unit of distance is kilometer and unit of time is hour. Now we will solve it. 2 5 ja 10 and 2 8 ja 16, 5 6 ja 30. So the speed of the object is, so the speed of an object can be calculated by in this way, 108 kilometer per hour. In such a way, dear students, we can convert from meter per second to kilometer per hour, or from kilometer per hour to, and from kilometer per hour to meter per second. This is the way of conversion of unit of speed in different physical quantity. Now, uniform and non-uniform motion. In everyday life, we seldom find an object moving with constant speed. I have told earlier, if an object is moving with same speed for a long distance, then this motion is known as uniform motion. If the speed of an object moving along a straight line keeps changing, its motion is said to be non-uniform motion. On the other hand, an object moving along a straight line with a constant speed is said to be in uniform motion. In this case, the average speed is same as the actual speed. Just we can see with the help of example, this is the station A, and this is the station B, and this is the station C. There are two cars. Car A This is the car A moving with A to B 60 km per hour. I am from B to C, its speed is also 60 km per hour. But a second vehicle B is moving with 40 km per hour from A to B. And from B to C, its speed is 50 km per hour. We can see that the speed of first car remained constant from A to B and B to C, where the speed of second car is changing. From A to B, its speed is 40 km, and from B to C, its speed is 50 km. So we can say that the car 1 having uniform motion, where speed is always remain constant, where car 2 having non-uniform motion. So this is the way by which we can understand the uniform and non-uniform motion. Units of speed. The speed of unit of speed depend upon the unit of distance and unit of time. We have told you earlier, speed is equal to distance divided by time. So the unit of speed depend upon the unit of distance and unit of time. The meter is standard unit of distance, and second is the standard unit of time. So the standard unit of speed is meter per second. This is very important, because in examination generally this is asked that what is the standard unit of speed. The larger value of speed are expressed in kilometer per hour, and in this case the distance traveled is measured in term of kilometer and in taken in measure in hour. So we can calculate the unit of speed either in meter per second. This is a standard unit of speed, and second unit is kilometer per hour. Small value of speed are expressed in centimeter per second. In this case, the distance traveled is term of centimeter and time taken is measured in second. If we have to compare the speed of number of object, then we must express the speed of all those objects in same unit. Just try to revise this. If we have to compare the speed of number of objects, if we want to compare the speed of car, speed of bike, speed of motorcycle, then it is very essential that the speed of all the objects are represented in same unit. Then only we can compare that which object is moving with faster speed and which object is moving with slower speed. Okay, dear students, thanks for watching complete video. Please like and subscribe our YouTube channel and also press the bell icon to get the information of the latest video. Okay, dear students, bye. We will meet very soon with our next video of this chapter.